Hey guys, how are you doing? And in this episode, we are going to see a very useful Mac application called Screen Studio. When you launch the application, this is all you see, a simple small box that says whether you want to record a single window or the entire display, or you want to add your microphone input. So you can press on start recording here. I'm selecting a single window, which is the system preferences window, and you will be given a small tooltip that confirms like how you can end this recording currently in progress. So here I'm fast forwarding this system preferences recording just for a demonstration purpose. Once I completed the recording, I have to press Control Command Option and R key. I can of course change it from the app preferences section, and here I'm greeted with a beautiful editing window, which gives me a complete control over the video footage that I have just recorded. For an example, here in the background section at the right side, you will get all the controls where, whatever the recording video output should be, you can decide and decorate, do all the customizations right there. And I can adjust the padding to give a focus to the window and how much wallpaper on the sides should be visible. I can decide that. In the bottom, you can clearly see, similar to any other video editing application, it has the entire video in first timeline. And in the second track, you can see several blue boxes or a block. We can, mention it as a block here. And these blocks are nothing but, the mouse clicks that you have performed while recording the video using Screen Studio, identified here. And you can drag and, simply extend the duration or reduce the duration by, pressing and holding that specific blue color block. And at the right side, when you tap on any blue color block, you can see at the right side the controls of it, whether you want that to operate based on the mouse clicks or based on the mouse movement or manual. Like if you select manual, you have to select which portion of the window zoom action to be performed. You can of course delete any existing mouse clicks that you find, if you find it unnecessary, and if you want to modify it, you can of course do it. It gives complete control over the screen recording that you have done, unlike any other application that I have come across. This is quite beautiful. And of course, one more thing I need to mention is this is kind of an early stage. The developer is constantly working hard to make this app really a beautiful one, a feature-rich one, and this is kind of an early stage, and it is mostly bug-free as far as I have tested for the past 1 week. I have never experienced any crashes in my Mac Studio, which I have recently bought, and it just works perfect on my M series machine, the M1 Ultra processor, so it should be working fine with the other M series machines without any issue. Coming back to the controls section, you can see below that background padding, you can choose whether you want to choose the wallpaper or the gradient, or if you want to put any separate color for each presentation to look in different with the different backgrounds. You can choose everything there. You can adjust the blur effect, the body, the ratio of the specific window that you are focused on, all these things at the top section of the tabs, the multiple tabs available. And you can of course adjust the cursor size of it. Like if you want to change the mouse cursor to an iPad like cursor, whenever we connect a mouse to our iPad, we can see this a gray color transparent icon. So that sort of circle icon can also be used here if you're recording your iPhone or iPad for presentation purpose. And you can see that the smoothness of this specific action that you have defined in the timeline section at the bottom can also be adjusted with several animation styles. That is really beautiful. By default, it sets with a mellow, and if you want to select it to be quick and rapid, you can of course adjust it. If you want it to be slow, you can change it there. And one other beautiful thing that no other screen recorder app has it is that this application's animation styles and everything, flow that you see on the screen, that smooth transition happens by following the Newtonian law. And you can adjust the tension, friction and mass of, with the overall fluidity, the animation style, and you will see the difference on the final output. So that is what I was saying, like this app gives more control over the video that you have recorded. And at the bottom left corner, you can see that you can choose different aspect ratio of the screen recording you have already done. That is amazing. Like if you have recorded it with wide angle 16:9 ratio, if you want to change it to vertical for YouTube Shorts or Instagram Reels, and if you want to make it as a square for just a regular Instagram post to show some screen presentations, you can of course do it. And finally, the export option provides you a simple window. By default, it's selected with MP4 file format for a video output. If you want to select it to GIF file, and if you want to select the frames per second FPS from 10 FPS to 60 FPS, it is also possible here. And the output file size can also be selected up to 4K, or the original size you want to preserve, you can choose. Of course, here I'm selecting 1080p. And the quality is also an important factor. Like if you want the output to be compressed a lot, then you can choose the web and web low. But I want it to be high resolution, so I'm selecting it as studio. And at the left bottom corner, you can see how much the estimated output file size is going to be. So it is right now 241.1. I have clicked on export file. I'm kind of fast forwarding this phase. And as a conclusion, if you ask me whether this app is worth or not, for, you know, when it comes to pricing, they charge you $89 for one Mac computer, and it is a lifetime license, as they clearly mentioned that you pay once and use forever. And if you want it for multiple Mac computers, then you have to go for the $139, which is suitable if you have multiple Mac computers or if you have a small team to share with. For more than that, you have to contact the developer, you know, for enterprise type of license. And the final conclusion is, if you ask me whether this app is worth or not, I feel that for $89 for one Mac, or for $139 for multiple Mac computers, up to 3 Macs, this is definitely worth. In future, they may bring a subscription plan. If you want to create a professional presentations, as I have demonstrated in the video throughout the workflow, then this app is definitely worth for the $89 price point. If you're already using Screen Studio in your Mac, do share your thoughts in the comments section so that other users who wants to buy may get a better idea. For more useful iPhone, iPad and Mac related tips and tricks, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you and have a wonderful day.